I think creativity is the core of invention. You start with a problem where the existing solutions just aren't adequate. And you ask yourself, how can I do this better? I loved creating from the very earliest memories I had. It was just Legos and motors and anything I could imagine, I would actually create. I got my first 3D printer when I was 16 years old, and it was incredible. I had a box that could make anything I could imagine within my bedroom. I started getting really into robotics, and eventually I made this full robotic arm that went on to win the state science fair in Colorado. And through that, I came to realize that a lot of the prosthetic technology available at the time could be these bulky, heavy devices with really limited motor function. And these arms could cost as much as $100,000.
That's the moment that I realized that this technology I've created, you know, for a couple hundred dollars in my bedroom, could really impact someone's life.
I've always had a limb difference. Like, ever since I was born, I never lost my arm or anything. It was just completely normal to me.
See it? Yes,
I remember, I think I was around 3 or 4 years old. We had this prosthetic, and I just remember when I put it on, it was, like, really uncomfortable. It felt like it was some sort of dead weight on my arm.
You know, that was kind of not a very good experience for her. Every time I would take it out, she would just take it and throw it out. She's like, Mom, I don't like it, so we are not doing this. We never pushed her to try prosthetic again.
I started to hear about how difficult it is for children to get good prosthetic devices.
The technology is extremely expensive. You outgrow it so fast. It could be heavy, bulky, hard to use. And so almost half the people who have a device don't wear them. And the more I dove into this problem, I knew I could come up with something better. And so I was 18 years old when I started the company Unlimited Tomorrow. We essentially went down the list of all the problems of the current technology and tried to fix all of them with our device. But we quickly realized that making a lifelike prosthetic limb is really hard. And on top of that, back in 2014, 3D printing was still very primitive. It could just print in a gray plastic. It was very, very brittle. And so the concept of even producing prosthetic limbs 3D printed in full color was such a far-fetched idea. But then a couple years ago, we started working with HP and we were told that they have a new color version coming out, combining everything we've ever wanted of like strong, durable plastic that's forgiving and full color. And for us, that was music to our ears. You know, we got a machine, and there was an incredible amount of learning, testing, refinement. But the point that we're at now, what we print is actually going out to the field, and a child is actually using this every day.
It was around a year ago that I finally felt like I was ready to try having another prosthetic. We heard about Unlimited Tomorrow, and it just felt like it'd be cool to try again.
Well, Aashna, it's so great to meet you. How's it going?
Oh, it's going pretty good. How are you?
We had to do like different kinds of fittings for the prosthetic.
When you push it in, mm-hmm. It starts to click.
Mm-hmm. They sent us 3 or 4 sockets, and we just sort of put it on and then test the comfort level.
Yeah, it seems pretty comfortable. I don't think that there's any like pinching or anything.
That's awesome. That's
yeah.
Great.
Wow. When it arrived, it was like, wow. It just looked like an arm, honestly.
Do you want to try to put it on?
When I put it on, I was really surprised when like the LED started working and like it just looked really cool.
Wow.
I think I was just really happy that it felt comfortable and it was moving when I wanted it to.
So once someone gets one of her devices, they go through muscle training. And so for Aashna, her device actually started learning her muscles and how she uses them.
What's your favorite grip so far?
Just where it's on green and the thumb is in, you can just kind of like go like that. I was slowly trying to train the muscles to get them to react and trying to like pick up things. Okay. Sometimes it would just drop out of my hand, but over time it just got easier to pick things up and put them down.
She reached a point where she was actually able to hold the ball. Seems like a small task, a small thing to do, but that was a big moment for us. And said, you know, yeah. Why don't you throw it to me? So she said, throw it to me, and I caught it, like, wow. Wow, you're getting good at this.
Can you make it little thin slices?
I'm really proud of myself because I'm like learning things and picking up things really quickly. I do have moments of doubting myself sometimes, but I've gotten through so many hardships in my life, and honestly, there's nothing I can't do.
My goal is to use this technology as a tool for someone to do the impossible or something they'd never dreamed of doing. So many things have to be right for this to work, and we're there, and that's just incredible.